to start from the start in a brand new spot. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Tanner's in Kimberly, a brand new venue for us anyway, for NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007. I'm the Thrill, he's Brody, and we got a packed card this evening, pal.
Huge show tonight. You'll be seeing some guys you may be familiar with, some guys you might not be, from some superstars from ACW, also from ICW in Milwaukee.
Not to mention NWA Wisconsin itself. It's our first show with a new expanded format. It's going to be phenomenal. Starting with a heck of a title defense, the man who very first held the NWA Midwest X Division title is returning to try to take his goal back from Jason Dukes. That's right, we're talking about formerly of TNA and of ROH, now back in NWA Wisconsin, the one and only Austin Aries, back in the ring tonight, Brody.
Austin Aries returning to his roots, coming back here to NWA Wisconsin and taking on Jason Dukes. You know, Jason Dukes, if he can keep his tights up, it might actually be a great match.
Dukes usually has to rely on chicanery to keep the belt. Tonight he's coming back to try and get that belt off the man who first held it ever in NWA Midwest. That's going to be huge. But that ain't the only piece of gold on the line tonight at Tanner's. The NWA Wisconsin heavyweight title is on the line again. Silas Young making his very first since winning a belt back. NWA Wisconsin title defense. He's got a heck of a guy on his plate tonight, Brody. He takes on Mason Quinn.
Mason Quinn, no slouch by any stretch of the imagination. And Silas Young, you almost kind of wonder what he's going to do considering it is his first title defense of that treasured NWA Wisconsin title this evening.
Mason Quinn hasn't held gold around here since 2003 when he was a tag team champion in ACW. Could he get his hands on NWA Wisconsin gold tonight? Only one way to know is to find out and see. This is basically a Pro Bowl of wrestling, ladies and gentlemen. Stars from NWA Wisconsin, ACW, ICW, Chicago, and all around the Midwest. Brody, this thing is stacked, man.
It's going to be a huge show tonight. Don't you dare go anywhere.
So don't put down the remotes. You don't need them. Grab a beverage. Let's get it going. It's time for wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I have been informed that I must introduce you all to Jason Dukes.
Let's kick this thing off. Welcome to Tanner's in Kimberly, ladies and gentlemen. This is NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007. Yours truly the Thrill, joined as always by my broadcast colleague, radio's greatest free agent, Brody. Brody, how we doing?
Good to be here alongside you as per usual. Thrill, gonna be one hell of a time tonight here at Tanner's.
And we seem to be kicking off a little bit early with the Midwest X Division champion, Jason Dukes, on his way to the ring. This man will defend the Midwest X Division title tonight against the very first champion in that category, the returning Austin Aries.
Austin Aries going to be here live this evening. We will look forward to seeing Austin returning to his roots as he has previously competed in ACW and NWA Wisconsin.
Here comes the champion, Jason Dukes, holder of the NWA X Division belt. And as always, Jason in not exactly the best mood.
Complaining about something, as per usual.
Yeah, don't know what. He appears to be heading away from the ring, and
is he getting a beer first?
He's heading to the bar here at Tanner's.
It's a little early for that, Jason.
No, wait, he's got a program.
Oh, I guess he wants to see his name in the paper.
And he just threw a chair in the ring. What in the world is the Midwest X Division champ up to? Let's listen, shall we?
I want to start by saying that tonight had very special meaning to me because it's just another chance to prove what a great X Division champion I am against a guy like Austin Aries. He's well respected, he's a great athlete. I'm not taking anything away from him. And then I saw this. Did you people see this poster? I cannot figure out why, in the good Lord's name, they have a big picture of Austin Aries holding my belt, and then right here in this little box is Jason Dukes.
He's referring to the free program, everybody gets at the door, full color.
Did you hear me? He gave me a 2-inch square. And in case you people missed it, in singles competition, you're looking at a man NWA ring in singles competition. That is a fact.
I think he's right, buddy.
So to disrespect me like this is nothing short of crap. And you know, not as well as you do. Now until somebody can get out here and explain to me how this has happened, I want the person who
hold on, hold those thoughts, champ.
Cut that music. Bring out the person responsible for this.
I don't know if this is the person responsible, but we're sure as hell going to get a nice surprise here, Thrill.
I haven't heard this in, well, maybe ever. And there he is. Ladies and gentlemen, Austin Aries has returned to NWA Wisconsin. Jason Duke's taking a powder. And the original Midwest X Division champion is in the ring, and he's got the belt. And now the stick.
I think that guy just called you a chicken. Shut up. You had your say, now I'm going to have mine. You're out here whining and complaining because you only got a 2-inch picture on the poster. You should be happy you can fit your chubby body in a 2-inch area at all. Now listen, I was the first Midwest X Division champion, and tonight in front of all these people in my stomping grounds, I'm going to once again regain this title. Because you're not the X Division champion. You're the 3XL Division champion. Take your belt now, enjoy it, because tonight it's coming home with me.
The one and only Austin Aries, back from TNA, back in NWA competition. He makes his first crack at regaining the NWA Midwest X title tonight here at Tanner's. Brody, this is going to be huge.
Things are already heating up at Tanner's Thrill, and we just started.
Keep it locked for more, folks. We're just getting going here. This is NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007.
He thinks he's going to take my belt? No way.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and has been issued a 15-minute time limit. Ladies and gentlemen, entering first, he hails from the nether void and weighs in at 210 pounds, the great Malaki.
Bringing you the best action from all around the Midwest, this is NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007. Here's truly the Thrill alongside Brody. And Brody, we're starting things off tonight with the Chicago Luchador Challenge.
You know, we actually don't know a lot about these guys, Thrill, but that's exactly the intriguing part of this show here tonight. It's not just ACW guys that you might be familiar with. It's not just ICW. We're bringing in guys from the entire Midwest.
Exactly. The cream of the crop in talent in this area. We started off with the great Malaki. This is one guy that we have never seen before here in NWA Wisconsin.
Yeah, showing a lot of class, already trying to bully our poor cameraman. Not exactly a big guy, and I guess he's trying to show how big of a man he is, the great Malaki.
Malaki looks like quite the specimen, but frankly, we don't know what this fellow brings
and
to the table.
Now, his opponent, weighing at 170 pounds, hailing from Saudi Arabia,
going international with the competition here tonight, Brody.
Absolutely. Another guy we don't know a heck of a lot about, Prince Ali. Seems a little mysterious.
Waiting on the entrance of Prince Ali, facing the great Malaki tonight in our opening match here at NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007. There he is, Prince Ali. Looking every bit the part, too.
Absolutely, and you know, a big smile on my face. But then again, you know, if I was a prince, you know, if I had the big oil money, I'd probably be pretty damn happy too.
You see him pointing a little bit there, reminiscent of the old Sheik, and maybe even a certain Sabu back in the day. Prince Ali with his debut match here in NWA Wisconsin, along with the great Malaki.
Hey! Oh, sorry, I'm not supposed to be a part of the crowd participation tonight.
Prince Ali apparently pretty happy to be here in NWA Wisconsin. Real happy to see everybody here at Tanner's and Kimberly. Frankly, so are we, Brody.
Absolutely, Prince Ali. Seems like a guy who likes to have a good old time, and I think he's all about that, and I think we're going to have a good time right away starting off tonight here in NWA Wisconsin.
Prince Ali is a big fan of America. He loves America. Frankly, it's a refreshing attitude to see these days.
Well, you know, with a lot of people who tend to hate on us here in America, outside of our country, it is rather nice to see.
The Great Malachi versus Prince Ali, your opening match here at NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007. Like you were saying, Brody, the best of the Midwest and even everywhere else here in our ring.
Especially in this match, the Chicago Luchador Challenge. If you're not familiar with the Luchador, high-flying action reminiscent of what happens down in Mexico.
Indeed, indeed. You used to see a lot of this stuff on broadcast TV back in the 90s. You can still see it on some channels south of the border. We're about to see some of it here in NWA Wisconsin. And now referee Jim Anderson.
Oh, come on. Look at that. Are you kidding me? Can you be any more disrespectful?
He just said his headdress does smell like camel.
I got nothing. I got nothing, bro.
Wonder which part of the camel. Maybe just
no,
the...
No, we're not. Family show.
Can't make that joke. Okay.
That's right.
The bell is rung here. We're underway. NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007 coming at you.
Ali already getting the fans behind him just after the bell rings. No big surprise.
Prince Ali Mighty is he right away getting ready to get it on for the Great Malachi.
Oh, and Malachi already throwing a little hissy fit. Poor baby.
Looks like the crowd here at Tanner's has chosen who they're backing, and they're definitely down with Prince Ali.
No big surprise at all. Good, fun-loving guy, as opposed to a guy throwing a temper tantrum like a five-year-old.
Exactly. But with two unknown quantities in that ring, Brody, poor referee Jim Anderson might have a hell of a lot to do there.
Yeah, Jim Anderson hasn't been reffing inside the four-sided ring, but, you know, it's been a while, but who knows? Maybe he'll be able to control this match.
Looks like the Great Malachi with a headlock there, taking advantage early on, controlling this matchup.
Did he just kiss him? I think he just kissed him, bro.
Wow, that's different.
That's an interesting way to gain control of the match.
Prince Ali now in control. Into the ropes they go. Prince Ali breaking the count there from referee Jim Anderson. The crowd here attending a little bit in stitches from the antics of Mr. Ali.
Well, yeah, absolutely. I don't know what to make of this. Well, I really don't.
These are two new guys to us, two brand new guys for NWA Wisconsin. He's got the crowd cheering along with him. He's obviously doing something right.
Absolutely. At least he's got something going for him.
And that's
got
to get under the Great Malachi's skin. Well, you know, Malachi taking advantage of the headlock there in the middle of the ring.
With a guy like Malachi already showing some signs of frustration, you know, it's obviously too easy to do that.
Oh, and taking it out right away on Prince Ali. Malachi off the ropes. Looking to bounce off again. Leapfrog, nobody home.
Uh-oh.
Up and where's this going?
Oh.
Down. Nice reversal there by Prince Ali. Followed up brilliantly. Drop kick and down goes the Great Malachi, who rolls out of the ring to take the powder.
Ali already with the crowd behind him, getting a few more of these great fans here at Tanner's behind him. But it looks like Ali's maybe even planning a little something.
Great Malachi's got to get back in that ring to beat the 10 count from referee Jim Anderson. Meanwhile, Prince Ali not waiting at all.
There
the
it
top
is!
Rope. Wow! Twisting over the top rope and landing square in the mush of the Great Malachi.
You know, I thought Ali was planning something there, and absolutely not disappointing.
Unbelievable. There's the luchador stuff you were talking about. There's the aerial maneuvers, Brody.
It's something that you think you would only see in Mexico, but oh no, it is here in NWA Wisconsin.
With a newly expanded NWA Wisconsin, you can see a lot here at a live show or on NWA Wisconsin home video. You never know what you're going to get, and that includes us.
Never know what's going to come out of our mouths. Whoa!
Good Lord! Prince.
Wow!
Are you kidding me? Flipping over the stairs, falling with a head scissors on the sport court here at Tanner's.
Absolutely phenomenal. You can tell that Ali is very well put together and a great athlete.
Ali taking nothing for granted and just going after Malachi with some very innovative moves. Unbelievable.
You almost wonder if Malachi underestimated Albert because he's obviously got a size and strength advantage. But, you know, Ali doing...
Look at this! Off the second turnbuckle, huge flipping right down, but it looks like he might have caught the knees of the Great Malachi.
Malachi actually did get those knees up just in time to just absolutely fluster Ali there.
And Malachi looking to have no more of this, but Ali continues with the offense, firing those rights into the dome of the Great Malachi. Over the ropes, no, a knee into the gut.
And there's that size and strength advantage we just talked about, Thrill.
Malachi puts him up, down!
Ooh.
Oh,
brutal move right there. And of course, Malakai, he's going to let the crowd know he's great. Yeah, that always gets you somewhere. Count of two, not enough. Malakai looking at referee Jim Anderson, not pleased with a pretty slow count there, and it did look a little slow. Great Malakai, now in control of this match, bouncing Prince Ali's head into those turnbuckles, ramming that shoulder into that solar plexus.
Three, come on, come on.
Him up and take over down. Malakai looking like he's all business right now.
And
here.
Look at this submission move, look at that shoulder lock.
Wow, and of course slapping him right there in that shoulder where it's being stretched. Trying to add insult to injury there.
Oh, but the armbar reverse, Prince Ali, now in top.
You know, with Ali, you would think that with all the high-flying moves he's already showed that he wouldn't try for a submission style. This is very strange.
Yeah, Prince Ali showed us early on that he can move and fly with the best of them. Now he's going for a power game, countered nicely by Malakai.
Malakai using that power and strength to his advantage once again to counter Ali in that surprising submission move.
Both men down in the 10 count administered by referee Jim Anderson. Pinfall count, cover two, not enough.
Ali just barely getting out there. It looks like we're coming down for a three count, but not quite.
You're looking at the Chicago Luchador Challenge, a first in NWA Wisconsin. And this is the kind of stuff you're going to see from us from now on with a newly expanded format. ACW in the fold, ICW in the fold. The best in the Midwest coming here, and look at the stretch move locked in by Malakai.
The abdominal stretch put on very, very well by Malakai, but it looks like Ali's still got some fight in it.
Up goes the Prince. Oh, shoots over the shoulders. He's got Malakai locked up. Reversal. Malakai now in control. And the rope throws the Prince up and down.
Ali felt all of that right there.
Nice flapjack by the great Malakai. Looking for the cover. Here we go. Count of two. And the Prince still has some fight left in his itis.
Absolutely. You would think that, you know, being royalty, he wouldn't have a lot of fight in him. You'd think he'd be pretty pampered, but he's definitely giving him all he's got.
And the great Malakai slowing things down now, going to that headlock, trying to take some of that energy, that win, that fight out of Prince Ali.
And that's exactly what you want to do with a guy who's smaller, all about the quick moves and the high-flying stuff. You want to keep him off his feet, not the match.
Exactly. That's what Prince Ali is going to fall prey to here. From Great Malakai, but the crowd at Tanner's will have none of it.
Crowd trying to get behind Ali and will him out of this move.
And it works, he's up to his feet, shot to the gut, trying to get out. He does, another boot to the gut. Malakai got him up and down with a nice suplex.
Big suplex, oh my God.
Rolling him over, looking for a pair. Nice gut wrench from behind and down he goes.
Almost shades of the late great Eddie Guerrero there for a moment.
Looking for a third one in a row, boom! Incredible move there by the great Malakai. Very, very nice.
And it looks like that took a lot out of Ali there, just barely seeming to exist on the mat there.
Great Malakai also going international with the German suplex, knocked a lot of the wind out of Prince Ali.
Now oh boy, is this guy going to go up to the top rope or what?
Looks like someone's going to the high red district. The great Malakai up in the air. Prince Ali pulling that up. Nobody home.
So sorry. So sorry nobody's home.
Prince Ali with just enough to move out of the way. Which man's going to get to their feet first in this one?
Ali trying to get the crowd behind him once again to get him motivated.
Both men up, Ali charges. Oh! Nice kick.
Big enziguri there from Ali.
Up goes Ali, look at the counter. Down.
Wow. Looked like a tilt-a-whirl DDT there, and Ali might have put him away.
Cover, count of two, not quite enough.
Ali thought he had him, and frankly, pretty much everyone here at Tanner's thought he had him, too.
Prince Ali looking to fight back, regain the momentum in this match. He may have done so. Looking it up, open up. Oh, nice European uppercut there.
A lot of international stuff here, Brill.
Absolutely. We're going all over the place here in NWA Wisconsin. Prince Ali looking to go up top.
Uh-oh.
All aboard Jay Malakai. He's in a bad spot. Rolls through with the victory roll. Cover. Count of two. And that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner at 7 minutes and 44 seconds. Prince Ali
victorious in his NWA Wisconsin debut at an intense opener, Brody.
And look at that big smile on his face. You gotta love a guy who can go through that kind of a match and just have this big smile on his face.
And still cheering along with the crowd here at Tanner's in Kimberly. Prince Ali victorious in NWA Wisconsin, the winner of our very first Chicago Luchador Challenge. More coming up after this. This is NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007.
NWA Wisconsin Showcase backstage at Tanner's in Kimberly with a couple of guys who have been on a world tour with Smiley Johansson back here for the first time in years, explicit content.
That's right. See, we've been training with tag team legend out of Idaho, Smiley Johansson, and he showed us the importance of tag team wrestling and teamwork. We're going to be back on the same page now. Explicit content, we're shooting back to number one, Daddy.
Okay.
Tonight, explicit content back in NWA Wisconsin for the first time in about 3-4 years. It's been a long, long, hard road back. But you're looking at the damn best tag team in the United States. This is the only tag team that in a week is going to be wrestling over in Portugal. There ain't going to be no bald-headed guys over there. There ain't going to be no long-haired guys over there. That's just going to be explicit content. The best damn tag team in the entire world, the entire universe. It doesn't even get any bigger than that.
International superstars.
So tonight, Mike Flannery, Jason Hades. We have a former MSPW champion. We have the current MSPW champion. Tonight, you two boys are going to learn a lesson. You're both fine singles wrestlers, but we're the best damn tag team there is. And tonight, we're going to kick your asses. Let's get out of here.
Well, a couple of singles specialists against an outstanding and legendary tag team. Explicit content tonight here at Tanner's.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a tag team match. This contest has been issued a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 423 pounds, the team of DDS and Bailey Mannix, Explicit Content!
And an old favorite returns to NWA Wisconsin. The Thrill and Brody here with you folks. And it's time for the return of one of the most successful tag teams in independent wrestling. And they're back, Brody. Explicit Content returns to NWA Wisconsin.
You know, Thrill, I'm surprised you're able to stay inside your shorts with the return of Explicit Content, an old school ACW favorite.
Indeed. Plus, they were tag team champions for 3 months back in 2004. These fellas are no stranger to NWA Wisconsin and to the gold around here. Now they're back in our ring, Brody.
Explicit Content back from a 3-year world tour with Smiley Johansson. They say, I talked to him earlier before the show, they said they learned a lot from Smiley, and they're glad to be back here at NWA Wisconsin.
Bailey Mannix and Danny Scott back in the ring. And these fellas, they're enjoying themselves. They're clearly glad to be back.
Absolutely, and I'm sure that Smiley is, well, smiling.
And they may be looking to do some damage to their opponents tonight, their former proteges down in MSPW. Explicit Content. And the fans here at Tanner's are going to learn real soon what they can make of these fellas.
And now, allow me to introduce their opponents. At a combined weight of 370 pounds, the team of Jason Hades and Mike Flannery.
Explicit Content faces their former proteges tonight. Here they come. Mike Flannery and Jason Hades, along with energy drinks, back in NWA Wisconsin.
I think that's an Irish energy drink, bro. That's what we call Guinness.
Oh, good Lord, you're right. They are cans of Guinness.
Kind of interesting there with the kid and the Guinness. That's not exactly the greatest example for those kids.
Flannery and Hades here in NWA Wisconsin, the current and former champions in MSPW. Bring along a little bit of Guinness, and they're throwing it to the crowd.
Hey, who doesn't love a guy giving away free beer?
Free beer, baby.
It's the best kind.
You can't beat that at all.
You know, everyone asks, what's your favorite kind of beer? I don't mention a brand. I mention free.
Good call, sir. Mike Flannery and Jason Hades, a couple of Irish guys who gave away their Guinness, and apparently here they do a little bit of damage to their to their mentors, standing on an MSPW Explicit Content. Former NWA Wisconsin Tag Team Champion facing off against their proteges. This could get personal in a hurry, brother.
Well, of course, you know, we've already got a little Irish jig being displayed there in the ring, mocking Hades and Flannery. This could get very, very interesting real quick. Referee Eric Yoda, he's got his hands full in this match.
Indeed.
Hades and Flannery already trying to get the crowd behind them, starting off this match with the legendary Explicit Content.
Lock up the ring here. Explicit content trying to look for an early advantage over their proteges. Reaching around, looking for that early advantage. It's always important to get that early advantage. And of course, we got Danny Scott getting the advantage there for explicit content. Right in the middle of the ring, that's exactly where you want to have your opponent, just so they can't get away and wear him down. Danny Scott with the size advantage, and that's what he wants to take advantage of here at the ring.
You better believe it, Brody. You can't, former champion back in the ring, and it wouldn't surprise me if somebody takes some liberties in this match between proteges and former masters, if you will. This could get ugly.
Explicit content, the wily veterans are already looking for a quick tag there.
And the rope he goes, coming out. No, he's ducking it. Up and, oh no!
Big head scissors there, wow!
Counter, nice, the arm drag, down goes Danny Scott. Come on,
that looks like Jason Hades up there with the advantage. Hold it down, Danny Scott.
Come on, let's go.
That's him, some people already noticing these Irishmen here. Look at that tag. Tagging the boot. Well, I guess it's whatever works. That's already some of the liberties that you were talking about there, Thrill.
And for crying out loud, I can't believe these fellas even gave away the Guinness. I mean, the gear itself is rather suggestive of a can.
That's a cheap pop right there. No pun intended.
Kind of makes me a little thirsty for Guinness.
Yeah, it's pretty bad when looking at someone's booty gives you a nose for Guinness. Especially a dude's booty. Oh, good lord. Sorry, Thrill. It had to be said.
Thanks a lot, man.
Good lord. Tag in the corner. Scott tagging out. In comes Bailey Mannix. And Flannery already taking him down. Taking down the fresh man inside the ring.
Mannix working that arm nicely, looking for the tag to his partner. There it is.
Come on, Flannery, let's go. One, two, three.
Jason Hades. Look at the double team action here. They got to beat that five count.
Look out. Going down. Double drop kick.
Brilliant tag team working there by the team of Danny Scott, Jason Hades and Mike Flannery.
And Bailey's in a bad way. Looking for the cover. Kyoto scooting over one. Ooh, not quite.
You know, Kyoto doesn't seem to like be keeping track of things very well.
Looks a little distracted there.
I mean, we've got Flannery still
going
in the ring
for the ride. Still going on the outside. Little assist. Nice shot, and down he goes.
Very well done there by the team of Hades and Flannery.
GDS bailing out to go check on his boy, Bailey Mannix outside the ring. Flannery and Hades alone inside the ring.
And again, referee Eric Chioti, he's got to get control of things here.
Look out, one and two! Double dive through the ropes, all four men out on the floor.
All four guys out there taking hard shots out on the sport court here at Tanner's. Referee Eric Chioti starting the 10 count.
Rolls him back into the ring there. Now that's the kind of move I was expecting to see in this match. A no hold bar hold, nothing back, just go all out at your opponent.
Absolutely, you expect brutality from all four of these guys in the ring.
Ducks the clothesline up and down.
Wow!
That was intense.
That was impressive there by Mannix.
Count of two, not enough to put the man down.
Very, very impressive moves there by Mannix, but then again, with the veterans that explicit content are, that's what you're gonna get.
Hades down on the mat there. Bailey Mannix in control. Up and down. Triple slam. Tag is made. In comes DDS.
Look at this.
And he's going to use his partner as a weapon.
Wow!
Almost a sit-out powerbomb. His own man. Cover still not enough.
And of course, Danny Scott not happy with the slow count there by Kyoto, but I don't think that was a slow count there, though.
I think Kyoto is doing as much as he can with this one. He's got his hands full, like you said. Oh, delicious Danny Scott going up against Hades. Fighting back now. Okay, he's going the eye pull.
Of course, that's the only good way to counter some good shots to the gut. Kyoto warns him. Into the rope. Here it comes.
Ooh.
Big shot from DDS. High impact clothesline there. And Hades, he probably doesn't know where he is right about now.
Delicious Danny Scott delivering all of that meaty forearm square to the mush of poor Jason Hades. Cover, count of two, not enough to keep him down.
Surprisingly, I mean, Hades, hell, that clothesline probably put him near Hades at that point in time.
No kidding, he's still just getting back up to his feet now. Oh,
whoa!
Rolls him up on count of two. Oh, he barely gets out of that one. Oh, DDS is a little incensed. Shoulder block and down goes Hades once again.
That seemed to light a fire under him right there and taking it out on his opponent, Jason Hades.
DDS backs him into the corner. Tag is made. In comes Bailey Mannix. Explicit content with a 2-on-1 advantage. Big kick there.
And here's where you see the experience of explicit contact, keeping their opponent in the ring, cutting off that ring, keeping them in their corner. And look at this!
Exactly. Flannery's isolated. Can't do a darn thing. He's coming in to equalize the odds. Keelan pulls him back out. And explicit contact remains 2-on-1.
Turn around, referee. Look at this. This is absolute garbage. Come on!
Haney's in a bad, bad spot between both men and explicit content. Tag is made. DDS. Delicious Danny Scott coming back in. Down he goes at the hands of Bailey Mannix. Mannix is up with a little assist from his partner.
Whoa!
Unbelievable. Cover. Count of two. Not enough.
But I don't know if Scott was even the legal man. Is he the legal man?
I don't
right
think
now?
So.
I mean, Kyoto's not seeing these tags. He's got to get on his game.
Okay, we're informed Danny Scott is in fact the legal man. And Jason Hades is frankly the man in trouble.
Hades needs to get out of there and tag in Flannery.
Time for chops and a big one there from DDS. This is Danny Scott throwing Hades in. Up for the ride, but no, looking for the sunset flip. It gets
sunset
it. Cover. Can't hold on to him though. And
uh-oh.
Delicious Danny Scott
uh-oh.
Is going to make him pay.
Oh, is he going for the Boston Crab here? He is.
The old school submission move. That will absolutely do lots of damage to your lower back, Brody.
Yeah, absolutely. I remember my brothers in the basement would put me in this move routinely, and it always hurt like hell.
And they always took your lunch money afterwards, didn't they?
Hey, how'd you know?
Who doesn't?
That was rude.
Middle of the ring there. Jason Hayes also being rude, too, in a bad way. Thanks to the Boston Crab. From the Delicious Danny Scott. Tries to get to the ropes. He does. He's got to break that hold.
Mannix seemed to be trying to hold that bottom rope away out of the reach of Hades, but not quite successful.
Tag is made. Mannix coming in now. Poor Jason Hades has got to make a tag and soon. His man Flannery is stuck on the outside all along.
He's taking quite a beating in there, and we got Flannery, the fresh man, outside. He needs to make that tag desperately.
Randy Mannix wiggling the fist, looking to throw him into the ropes. Uh-oh, little fight back from Hades.
Look at that!
Wow!
I don't even know how to call that, Thrill.
I'm just going to say wow.
I think that serves, that's pretty well descriptive. How about fantastic, phenomenal?
How about a double underhook Canadian destroyer?
Oh!
And a nice enziguri to boot!
And Hades.
Finally,
he got the
tag! In comes Mike Flannery. Finally gets his chance. Use some damage to explicit content. Inverted atomic drop. Have another one.
He's coming at him like he just finished off his last Guinness.
He's not sure what to do this time. Which one do we hit
uh-oh,
first?
Uh-oh, meeting of the minds.
Double noggin knocker. Both members of Explicit Content dazed now. Flannery, the House of Fire, looking to do some damage to those guys who have been absolutely cracking his opponent.
Ooh.
Huge kick and down goes DDS.
Big shot by the Fighting Irishman there, Flannery.
Cover the middle of the ring. Count of two, not enough.
Flannery's, he's got more. He's got more for the other members of Explicit Content.
Here's a few shots for you, Bailey Mannix.
I think he probably doesn't like the fact that Bailey Mannix is insulting the name of Bailey's.
Couple more shots into the corner there. Flannery's got some plans for Mannix. Into the corner he goes. Comes out, up, and down!
Big backdrop there by Flannery.
Flannery going for the cover. Count of two broken up by DDS.
Danger, Delicious, Danny Scott, whatever the heck you want to call him, absolutely saving his partner there. But Kyoto, again, needs to get both these guys out of the ring. Where's the 5 pound?
Well, it's kind of hard to keep these guys in check. What in the world was that?
I don't know, but it sure as hell looked like it hurt. But again, we've got absolute mayhem in there. Kyoto does not have control of this.
Flannery down for the T-bone suplex. Jason Hades fighting back now against DDX. Bailey Mannix also flat in the ring. Man, this is quickly getting into a pure four ball. Oh, big kick from Hades. Look at that double underhook. Good lord, he's going with submission move.
Wow. Just screaming for him to tap. Hades
yelling. Uh-oh, Flannery up and over the edges there thanks to Mannix. Mannix breaks it up nicely.
And Hades is in trouble. Look at this. Double team, double team.
The 2-on-1 for Explicit Contact. Suplex counter into that pin, and Flannery breaks it up.
You know, it's a good thing for Flannery and Hades that they were so close to the rope there. If that would have been on the other side of the ring, it would have been over.
Flannery now looking to put this thing away. He's got Mannix up. Ooh, Bailey Mannix fights back nicely. Off the ropes. Here comes Flannery.
Ooh.
Big kick, and down goes Bailey.
Big boot straight to the dome.
Throws him up, counter two, not enough.
We also got action outside the ring here, Thrill, Hades, featuring Hades and Scott.
Hades and DDS are going at it here on the sport court floor here at Tanner's. Oh, Hades takes the ring.
We got action inside the ring. We got it outside the ring. Absolutely awesome.
Here comes that brawl we were talking about, folks. Flannery looking to do some damage to Mannix. Mannix counters.
Uh-oh.
Bridge, counter two, counter three.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by pinfall at 10 minutes and 5 seconds, Explicit Content!
What a battle, Brody! You know, I'm actually tired just from watching that throw. I really, really am. Explicit Content coming away with the win, but no surprise being rather crafty while doing that.
The Tiger Suplex does the job for Explicit Content. The former tag champions are back in NWA Wisconsin. And you saw Bailey Manic here, folks. They're looking for NWA Wisconsin tag team gold. More from Tanners here in Kimberly. This is NWA Wisconsin Showcase 2007.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to introduce you all to your promoter for NWA Wisconsin. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Jason Jerry.
Here comes the boss, Jason Jerry, the owner and head promoter of NWA Wisconsin. Come on, Brody, even you like the disco music.
No. I like Jason Jerry, but I'm not willing to kiss ass that much.
Here comes the boss.
How you doing, fans? Thanks for coming out tonight. If you didn't grab a free program, I just want you to go over there and grab a free program so you can check out the upcoming shows for our affiliates, ICW in Milwaukee and ACW in Green Bay. Keep watching NWAWisconsin.com, and we'll let you know when we're going to return here for another NWA show here at Tanner's. We're going to work out the calendar, but we love it here at Tanner's, and we will be back. That's a fact. Thank you.
Hell yeah.
Now we have some fitness to take care of here tonight. I would like to bring out the two men who will be defending the NWA Wisconsin Tag Team titles tonight, Dysfunction and Arya Tavari.
Kind of a makeshift team we got here, Brody. But they're defending the NWA Tag Team titles tonight. Dysfunction and Arya Tavari. Come on out.
Yeah, Arya Tavari actually taking up one half as Tag Team champions because, well, I guess we got someone missing in action here tonight, Thrill.
Yeah, that's from the latest word we have from Esteban Molina, co-holder of the NWA Wisconsin Tag Team title, is that he's off on a tour in Australia. We haven't heard hide nor hair from Esteban.
Well,
but these two do have a history, Brody. And down in ICW, these two tag up frequently.
They do, we've heard, and they do so
yeah,
very
so
well.
We found out that Esteban Molina was going to be in Australia for a while. The board of directors decided that Arya Tavari would be able to defend one half of the tag titles tonight. Because this is a big, big show, and we wanted to make sure these belts were on the line tonight. And he's the best man in my mind for this. However, there's a little hitch that happened. And Esteban Molina showed up.
What? Early. Are you kidding me?
And he... Yeah, well, he has something to say and asked if he could take this moment to come out and try and work things out and see how we're going to proceed tonight. So if you would, please, Esteban Molina.
This is a development we did not see coming, Brody.
You know, he must have just flown in from Australia or something like that, because this is very, very bizarre.
We thought he was a whole continent and ocean away, but here he is, technically half of the NWA Wisconsin Tag Team Champions, Esteban Molina, and his belt's already in the ring around the waist of Arya Tavari.
Molina looking a little upset that he doesn't have his strap around his waist.
He's fine with Dysfunction, clearly not fine with Arya.
So, I go on tour, and NWA decides that he's going to take my spot in the tag team title match tonight. I don't think you deserve this.
Why not? He's got nicer hair than you.
For those of you scoring at home, that's one hair joke for Dysfunction.
Well, I don't know about that. But I honestly don't think you deserve it. You got to earn this title, buddy.
Ooh.
It's on your face.
Honor point?
I gotta earn it?
Yeah, that's the truth. You gotta earn this. I earned it.
How about this? For the tag team championship match tonight, I challenge you right now for your title.
Well, that's a good way to solve the problem.
Winner gets to be Distance Partner and gets one of those two pieces of gold. I like it.
What do you say, Esteban?
No problem.
I like the idea. I like that. But I think it's up to somebody in here.
Got to run it by the boss. Jason Jerry, what do you say?
The crowd wants it.
Yeah. Pretty good.
There's a guy over there. Does Ed Schumann want it? Because Ed Schumann's in charge of this.
Yep, Ed Schumann from NWA Midwest.
Ed Schumann would like to see it, so apparently we have a match to start right now.
Okay, Judge Miz late. Let's get it out. And how do you like that, folks? A little bonus
ladies
match here.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the black trunks,